Welcome to the Playa Del Carmen NOW podcast.
Welcome to the Playa Del Carmen NOW podcast.
All right, great. And today we are going to be talking about music or bands in Playa Del Carmen.
Great. Great. We have a great guest today.
So. Yes, we do. We do have a great guest today. We have Jimena.
Jimena.
Hola.
Jimena. Jimena. Hola. Jimena just had her band, the
La Mafia.
The Mafia. The Music Mafia. We got to be careful how mafia. We say the word mafia here, yes. In Mexico.
Everywhere, Ken. It's not just Mexico.
Yeah.
Okay,
everywhere.
You're right. You're right.
It's so actually Italian. So
yeah, exactly.
It's Italian. Oh, okay. So Jimena is one of the well-known musicians with the band in Playa del Carmen. She's been here for, Jimena, how long have I known you?
Known each other about 7 years.
7 years.
7, 8 years, something
I'm
like that.
I'm sure it's more.
Yeah. It's probably, yeah. She's,
yeah. Once you bring the date, you
yeah,
will see,
it's probably
around 14.
It's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay, like that.
We'll keep it that way. So before we start talking about music and bands in Playa del Carmen, let's first talk about Jimena.
Oh, thank you.
So Jimena, you're Mexican, correct?
I am Mexican.
And where are you from?
La Ciudad de Mexico. Mexico
what?
City.
What? Oh, Mexico City. Got it.
CDMX.
Así
by
es.
Now.
Así es.
Okay, so she's a Mexico City girl, and she's been in Playa del Carmen NOW for how long?
9 years. This is my ninth year here.
9 years in Playa del Carmen.
2013.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Sí,
that
sí,
was
sí.
fast, right?
That was
But it was joyful, right?
It's been very joyful, and it's been all full of music. There's a lot of music here, so I'm happy.
Nice, sí. Nice. So. Sí, sí. What brings you to Playa del Carmen?
Well, mostly the beach.
Okay.
Yeah, the Caribbean beach. That is just wonderful. You know, the sea here is like, yay.
Yes, and that's a great reason and a very popular reason
why
people come.
Very popular. And that and the music, being able to work and live off music.
Yes.
It's, I mean, beach
and
music.
And you've had some amazing things in your career. That I'm going to talk about.
Okay.
But before we even get there.
Yes.
We ask this question. We ask two very specific questions to every single guest. And the first question is, when friends or family come in town, what tour or where do you take them?
Oh, okay. First of all, I bring them to the beach, of course, and to La Ruta de los Cenotes.
Oh.
Yeah, because Puerto Morelos is one of my favorite places, and La Ruta de los Cenotes, being able to dive into, you know, a water hole, transparent water where you can just lose yourself. Like we were talking about the
headset.
The headsets, exactly.
The escape.
Exactly. You feel like the same sensation when you're into the water in the cenotes and in sweet water, and it's amazing. I love it.
So cenotes, yes, that's a very popular one. Which is your favorite cenote?
It's called Esmeralda.
Esmeralda.
Aha.
And that's the one in Puerto.
And it's the Ruta de Cenotes in Puerto Morelos, and it's about 5 kilometers into the ruta.
Which is just south of Playa del Carmen, not very far from town.
No, it's 30
north.
Minutes.
What?
Yeah.
North.
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 Uh-huh. And it's
what did
30
I say?
Minutes.
I said south.
South.
Yes. Depends on how you're standing.
Okay, the second big question we ask everybody, what is your go-to restaurant that you take everybody to?
Oh, my God.
There's got to be a go-to restaurant. And before you answer this,
okay.
I just want to tell you, this is probably about the we've exceeded 20 episodes right now.
Oh my God.
And not once has a restaurant been repeated.
Nice.
And let's see if this happens again.
Okay. Well, mine is it's also in Puerto Morelos.
Okay, so
it's going to be new.
It's going to be new.
It's called El Campanario.
El Campanario. Tonayo.
And it's delicious because it's traditional Mexican food.
Traditional Mexican food.
And it's made by Mexicans for Mexicans
beach,
and
right?
everyone else. See, it's,
and it's on the beach.
One.
And I think I know where that's at, too.
Yeah, and it's delicious.
Yes.
what do you like from that place?
Enchiladas.
Exactly. That's what I wanted to know. Enchiladas.
And they have wonderful cuts, you know?
Okay. Like
arrachera taquitos, yum.
Yes. We love that.
Sí.
Okay, so awesome. So here we go. Another episode, new restaurant. It's just out of town.
Yes.
But it's
worth it.
It's on the beach. It's worth it. Yeah. And she goes to Cenote. So fantastic. So let's move on. Today is, it's a recorded show, but today is Independence Day in Mexico.
Así es.
Viva Mexico!
Viva Mexico!
Some viva Mexico.
And,
Yes.
And Jimena and her band, The Mafia, just finished playing on the beach at the Asi Beach Club.
Okay.
Where we were having a promotion, an interesting promotion, free pizza and beer.
It was very interesting. Delicious.
Ah, great.
My kind of promotion.
Free pizza and beer. At the beach club for 2 hours and live rock and roll.
And live rock and roll.
So go ahead, Javi, tell me what you think. We did a Facebook Live out there.
We've been saying this, Jimena. For me, and maybe for you too, this was my first time celebrating Independence of Mexico with pizza.
With pizza.
And
nice.
Rock and roll at the back. So it's normally pozole or quesadillas or pambazos or whatever Mexican meal and mariachi at the backgrounds. But today it was pizza and rock and roll with an amazing voice that we are going to talk about it.
Gracias. You know what the thing is with Mexico? That there's enough space and place for everything and everyone.
Amazing. Aplausos.
Yes, aplausos. Yes, that's
so,
an amazing
so you
comment.
Can so you can include everything in your independence celebration. Yes. And being able to just celebrate it and yes. still celebrate it and have it is, I think, it's like a yay.
We are a warm culture, so si. We like to do that, right?
Yeah.
Anyway.
And here I'm gonna give the excuse because I did get a lot of flack. I did get a lot of feedback from staff, friends. Actually, I was over at your party. As a matter of fact, I was at his birthday party, and I was telling all his Mexican friends that we're gonna have free beer and pizza, and he's like. They were like,
there's
pizza?
Something. Yes, there's
not tacos, not something, nothing Mexican. You're going to have pizza? And I go, yeah. Hey, the hotel's filled with gringos, you
yeah.
know?
Yeah,
and
I'm Mexican.
You know what? Italian flag is almost as Italian. Yeah, Mexican
as
flag.
Mexican
so.
Flag.
And you know what? I don't think, if you're having a party and you're giving free anything, I don't care what it is, I think everybody's going to be happy.
Yeah, I think so too.
Chinese food, right, for the next year.
And it's funny that you have like the so-called Mexican beer, La Corona.
Yes.
It's not Mexican anymore, people, so.
And that is so true. But that's what we did today, and we're looking to relive that tomorrow. So if you're around, well, I can't say this because by the time this is...
it'll be way past.
But... we do have these kind of celebrations during the holidays, so it's always a good reason to come to Playa del Carmen.
Yes, it is.
And the other good reason to eat pizza during the day is because typically when you celebrate independence, it usually starts around a lot later than 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
I know.
Totally.
Because like I was, again, I'm going to refer to the Facebook Live, Javi says, all right, Javi, when do Mexicans celebrate independence?
We are used to celebrate by night.
By night.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
We usually start around maybe 6 o'clock or so.
6?
Yeah. See, later, later.
Even later. Yeah,
yeah, because the grito, no? The
sun hasn't even gone down. You don't see Mexicans going out to party at night when the sun is out?
No, when the sun is out, no.
Never.
No, you start getting ready at 6, so you'll be out at 8,
yes,
having the tacos and pozole and everything, yes, and at 11, then you have the Viva Mexico and everything, and then you go until tomorrow, and then it's, yes, Saturday and Sunday.
And so especially for this year, we have a long weekend, so sí, the party is going to be long.
Ah, sí? Until, yeah, Monday?
I mean it's Friday, tomorrow is Friday, then Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah, by Sunday you will be like...
How's your voice by that kind of celebrations? You are going to still working or?
Yeah, I'm gonna be working tomorrow and Saturday.
Oh,
and,
my God!
And by Sunday I will be like,
you better sitting on the beach,
resting,
not saying a word.
She prefer to,
yeah,
text.
I'll be texting.
So speaking about The Voice,
yes,
and we all know about the very famous show The Voice.
Yes, worldwide.
Worldwide, and then there's The Voice Mexico.
La Voz.
La Voz. Spanish.
She, yeah, was there.
What?
She was on. That was what, 3 years ago, right?
3 years ago, just before the pandemic.
Oh.
1994. No, oh my God. You see? 2019.
2019.
Yeah.
You were on The Voice, and how far? You made it almost.
Yeah, semi-finalist.
Semi-finalist.
Yeah. I'm going to try again.
You're going to try again?
I really liked it. It was an amazing experience, and the crew and the production guys and all the thing. It was one of the best experiences I've ever had.
Great.
See.
And I remember watching the first couple episodes. Well, the first episode, because it's a song that you sing. Well, I've had you at many of my parties. Yeah. I've had many parties with the company and end of the year parties. You've been. You've always been our voice.
Yes.
For around me. She does a lot more than rock and roll as well. I mean, she does have that strong, powerful female voice. It's quite amazing, and it was very, and even the voice representatives, the judges,
yeah,
were shocked. They hit the button. They all hit the button within the first minute. It was just amazing. They were just like bam, bam, bam. So she knocked it out of the park, and. I think I was traveling in the semifinal, and I didn't get to see that episode.
Okay.
And I think I messaged you and said, "Hey, how'd you do?" And you were like, eh.
"I'm coming back."
But you do have an amazing voice, and
I mean, semifinals is something that we might start considering as something normal, or oh, you did not get to the finals, but how many people? Can get to,
you know,
to
the
that.
Thing is that just being able to get into the TV show,
exactly,
it's like it's thousands of people that send,
yes,
their videos to be able to just go and audition, and once you are there it's hundreds of people, and to that tiny little group, I think it's like 20 that go to the
yes,
semifinal.
And we are in a huge country with a lot of people.
With
here,
a lot of people and a lot of talent. And
yes,
everyone had an amazing voice there. There was no one that you would say, like, maybe. No. All big time voices and very young.
Yeah, they can belt it out.
See,
the girl that went up against you that one time, I was like, wow.
Yeah.
The young girl. I can't remember her name, but. You were up against a young girl, I think, in round two, or I believe round two. And she was, when I heard her, I was like, oh, my.
Oh, my. Yeah,
oh
amazing voice.
But then you came out and you belted another song out again, and it was, yeah, so.
And, Jimena, what was the beginning from this story of singing?
Well, my dad was a singer, too.
Okay.
So always in my house there were musicians and rehearsals and music playing, and I started going on tour with my dad when I was 6 months old. So it's always been
there's a big percentage of people that is related with music that comes with the family, right?
Yeah.
Like it's not something that happens just for one that grew up with listening, whatever.
They get born with the ear.
Exactly.
Because the ear is, you know.
Yeah. And the influence about people.
I think the influence was the biggest thing, because we are not traditionally like listeners of Mexican music, without offending anyone. But my dad used to be a funk singer. and a soul singer.
Okay.
So you
in Mexico City?
See, in Mexico City. So you would hear James Brown and Aretha and, oh, and wow. the Supremes and all. That's my childhood music. No, it's the
that's why that, you that, sing it.
That's how
with
I grew up.
That feeling.
Yeah. So I can do Mexican singing and music and everything, but my soul just trembles when I hear soul music, and
nice.
It's like, yeah, I need it.
We can see it. See? We can see it. Yes.
So, Jimena, if somebody's coming into Playa del Carmen and they want to see you,
yes,
where do you typically? Do you have a regular place? Or?
Yes, I do. I'm every Friday from 8 to 10 at La Vagabunda on 5th Avenue. It's a really nice place.
Up there.
A few blocks from here.
Just north of us.
Exacto. Yeah. And it's really nice because you can come have dinner. They have amazing cuisine. Very good Mexican cuisine. And on Saturdays, every other Saturday on Sensi Beach.
Okay.
And you can come and dance and have a great time. And the other Saturdays, I'm at La El Caimán.
Oh, nice.
Come on.
Caimán.
El Caimán. It's a...
I don't know that place.
Oh, you should come.
Yeah. Do I it's know on, that place? I probably know it. I just don't...
It's around it's 24, 20, uh-huh, 22
exacto.
Maybe?
Si.
In 5th?
22, uh-huh. Yes.
On
the corner. Mm-hmm. Between 5th and the first one. The first avenue.
Yeah, 1st and 5th and 24, I think.
Yes. Oh, okay. Yes. Now it's coming to me. Okay.
Yeah, so you can find me there. And any of them places are really nice. And if you can dance, if you want to come and have dinner, or if you want to come with friends and have a few drinks, it's just...
And you do this with now the new, this new mafia band, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Right. Because you've been around with a few bands.
Yes, I have.
You still have a good relationship
yes,
with some of those.
Yes. You know, there's many musicians in Playa, but I've been able to know and play with many great ones, and we are always... Actually, one of them was here today, the drummer, Josh Flores, that has been here, like, forever. And when I got here, he was one of the first that employed me and told me to sing with this band. But now I have my band.
Oh.
Now this is my band.
Congratulations for it.
Yes.
Yes, she has her own band.
Now I have my own band, exactly.
And how does it work to lead a band? Because you need to be a leader.
Yes, you have to. You have to. You know what the most difficult thing is? To be able to have a steady job with a good pay. Okay. Especially coming back from the pandemic.
Yes.
Many places are still paying like the pandemic
wages
and rates. And it's like, no. Especially with the inflation, you know how it is here.
Yes.
No, and we cannot earn the same thing we were earning 5 years ago, and then it went like half in the pandemic.
Yes.
And they still want to pay that. And like, nah.
But it's busier now, though, right?
I mean, it is busier, but it's not a lot of money.
Really? It's still not. I'm surprised. I'm surprised because
you should be, no?
It's. I thought it was coming around. I noticed. I mean, honestly, when I contacted a few bands for today and tomorrow, of course I contacted you first. And I always contacted just others just to make sure you tell me, no, I'm busy, because I know you're busy. I know you're always busy. And it was almost a kind of a last-minute thing when I contacted you. And a lot of the bands I contacted were like, no, we're busy. Mm-hmm. And it is a holiday.
Yeah.
But most of the bands are playing. So are you playing tonight?
Yes.
Oh. I remember those days. I was a musician. The two per day were the tough ones.
Sí. And also tomorrow and also Saturday.
Plus podcast.
Yeah.
And then we're going to throw a podcast into the whole mix. Yeah.
Let's mix it up.
Yeah.
Get yourself on a microphone and talk for 30 minutes. Wonderful.
Oh, I have no problem.
Well, it's different to talk against singing.
You know,
right?
it's what I do, so...
Yes.
I haven't ever gone being without a voice ever.
And
so
now going back to this La Voz, to this program, how you arrived there? How was your
It's
your
a very
way?
Cute story.
Okay.
I have one of my best friends, Alejandra Camus. she called me and said, I did something.
What?
Oh.
I just did something.
Oh,
and
no.
I'm like, what did you do? I read, no, a post in Facebook, and they are starting to look for people for auditioning for The Voice, and I sent your video, and they said yes.
Oh, so you
and they are so calling you.
Amazing story.
Oh, that's so you didn't even send
no,
it.
When I didn't even know. And wow. She was like, and they are calling you. Please say yes. And I said, of course I'm gonna say yes.
Wow. Of course. Those are friends, yes. Right?
Same.
Oh, wow.
It depends on the side that you see it, because some other people might say, hey, what are you doing with
what
my life?
No,
I don't want to go in that places, but...
Oh, she knows me. She knows. I'll
so where did you go? The Voice. Where did you go? Where was the...
Mexico City.
It was Mexico City.
Yeah, I had to flow. I had only one request because they told me, okay, so you come and you audition. And I was like, I will go wherever you want me to go. But I have a child. As long as I can bring my... See, of course. Just tell me. And
oh
they
my
flew,
God.
They flew us both, and I was able to audition. So I'm telling you, they are really nice people and very considerate, and they know how to treat artists. No, it's not like hey, no. They were really, really nice and sweet with me, and I was just traveling around with my baby to be able to
superstar.
Go.
See, that's
yeah.
Amazing. That's
See.
An amazing story.
See.
So
See.
You have somebody from Playa del Carmen,
yeah,
in a famous show. In Mexico City. I mean, that just shows you that there is a lot of great talent here.
Oh,
yes.
For sure.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
We are the talent.
Undoubtedly.
We are
there's
here.
There's a lot of talent.
I mean, I'm here. Oh. So, wow. I didn't know that story. Wow, that's really
Isn't
cool.
Isn't it nice?
That is
yeah,
a super
it's the nicest.
Cool story.
I know. I really like
and
it,
what,
too.
What does,
I like
what was the song that you that your friend sent to this audition?
I think it was Piece of My Heart.
Okay.
A video with Piece of My Heart. Yeah.
But
because when I got there, they were like, so you're singing this, right? And I'm like, yeah, okay. Of course I am.
You just tell me what I had to do.
Let's go.
And how last that? How long does it last, this audition or this from the point that you arrived to Mexico City and then...
Okay, so they flew us like one day in the afternoon. I had four travels there and back. The first one was to see them and rehearse for the audition.
Okay.
And I came back. It was like I go to today and tomorrow I was back.
Just to rehearse.
Uh-huh, just to rehearse with the band. Okay. And then they flew me back again and I went Tuesday night and the audition was Wednesday night and then I passed and on Thursday morning I was back. And like that, like three, four times, no? So it was like a rock star.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
And before Playa del Carmen, you used to also sing in Mexico City, right?
I was singing in Mexico City. I had a band. It's called Los Sabrosos.
Okay.
And it's a blues band. And
all your life has been more to the blues and soul,
yes,
and this kind of
yes
things that you were sharing
the blues,
right now,
soul,
right?
Funk, disco, rock.
You will not. People is not going to be finding you like mariachi style or. So.
You know, I can do it too, and I like cumbias, and I like salsa, uh-huh, and I like everything. But I think my
your path.
See, yeah, I definitely
yes
think I'm more in this.
So where did you learn to speak English so well?
My grandfather. And he was born in Texas.
Oh, okay.
And my mom got me into a bilingual school when I was like this. And every family gathering, he would like pull me over and sit me down and speak to me in English and English and English and English and English. And my father sang in English and my music was in English. And my so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was part
MTV
of your life.
MTV.
Yeah. MTV for me too.
See,
that's why sometimes I just speak like Californian stuff.
See. It's like I'm an MTV child.
Yes.
Because you're singing everything, but most of the things that you sing well, especially around me, because
yeah,
is in English.
Mm-hmm.
Although I did at our Christmas party last year, or end of the year party, you sang
I spanked some salsas and some cumbias too.
Yeah, you sang quite a bit of Mexican dancing, yeah. Of course, because it was that was what was going on.
Yeah, I can adapt, of course. I mean, I speak Spanish.
Yeah, for me, this MTV thing changed my life when the TVs or the shows start
having the subtitles,
the closed caption, like,
claro,
oh my God, now claro. I can read. That was an amazing time.
Si.
Sorry, I got a call there real quick, and it disrupted me. So yeah, what is your favorite song to sing?
Oh my God! Right now, it's "I Try" from Macy Gray. I really enjoy it. And "Rock with You," Michael Jackson's "Rock with You." Oh, I love that song.
So which song do you find super challenging that you force yourself to sing?
Oh. Any Whitney Houston.
Any Whitney. Oh, my God.
She's on the top. She's on the top.
Yeah. I think Whitney, I grew up with her. You know, it was like the Bodyguard CD playing in my house. Like, oh, my God, I don't know. Get her another one. But I know every song in that CD. So, yeah, Whitney.
Whitney
and Tina Turner is
well. I've seen you. I've seen you.
You go for the top, man.
Yeah.
Well, yes.
that has to bring the best part of you. Can imagine.
Exactly.
When you go for high, you better work on it.
Yeah, I better work on it. Yes. Exactly.
That's fantastic. I love it. And it, you know, she even motivated me. I was a musician. super many years ago. One of my childhood things, and last year at the Christmas party, I don't know what you did to me, but I did go up.
I opened the box.
You opened the box. You got me going.
Yeah.
I got up there, and I was playing the guitar. And I hadn't touched the guitar 7 years. 7 years. Never even picked one up. Yeah, because I think the last time I touched the guitar was at my wedding. My wedding, I got... Got that same thing. One of the bands opened that box, and I got up there, and I was singing, but that was.
And you were so
good. That
was
drunkenness.
You know what the thing is with musicians, that when people see and feel how much you are enjoying it, it's. I think it's everything.
Yeah, it gets in your blood.
Exacto.
You get in your blood when you're.
It's all you need.
Yeah, you get up on the. You get up on the stage and you're playing and you're grooving and as long as you're sounding good.
But it's
I unplugged.
Oops. Jazz note.
on the other hand, it's not for everyone. Okay, I mean, to be a musician, to have this passion, to know levels. I don't know, a lot of techniques.
To live with it.
Yeah.
Because there's many people who can play and many people who went even and studied music and everything, and they live off of something else. But, you know, diving into the whole musician life, it's not for everyone.
You've been doing this for long?
Forever.
Forever.
professionally, about 20 years.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And before that, what were you doing?
Traveling.
Yes.
It was a bump.
That sounds interesting.
Yes. I was just traveling and going around. And
That's also
I've
something
been a
related.
Waitress. I've been working at an accessory store. I've been a...
We've all done this.
Of course. A bartender. Well,
artist.
I was 20-something, no? But I started,
I was
like
a disc
singing.
Jockey. I was a disc jockey before I was playing music.
You see? And then it was like, okay, I need to... Okay. Let's do this.
Yes, it's super exciting. Yeah. It's super, super, super exciting. All right. Well, Jimena, thank you so much for being on the show. You did an amazing job. But before we let you go, we have to talk about today's promotion. In every podcast, we do some kind of promotion so that you can come to Condo Hotels Playa del Carmen and stay in one of our properties and maybe, just maybe, come and check out Jimena in one of her locations.
Yes.
So the promotion we are doing today, special promotion, for November and December, is going to be #music. #music is going to get you an additional 15% off of any reservation for November, December, not including Christmas. Sorry.
Not including Christmas.
And that'll be 15% off of this year, 2022.
Nice.
Yeah, sounds interesting.
Yeah.
So hashtag music, you come here, go to the front desk, and ask the front desk, where is Jimena at? And they will give you that information.
Oh,
or a concierge. Perfect. Concierge will have
excellent.
That information.
Please let me know when you're there so I can
and
say, hey,
before,
hey,
before
hey.
We forget it, how can people find you?
Yes.
I'm on every
platform.
Platform with Jimena with a J. J-I-M-E-N-A.
Yes.
Segovia.
Segovia.
Segovia with an S, the small B. Segovia. S-E-G-O-V-I-A. Segovia.
That's perfect.
And you know, we didn't ask you. Do you write your own songs?
Yes, I do.
You
do? I have original songs too.
She has original songs.
Yeah. Oh,
that's another level for musicians,
yeah.
Right?
Yes. Writing your own songs is a whole nother. Playing other people's music is it can be easy.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Or it, you know, you graduate through it. But then writing your own stuff,
yes,
that actually sounds good.
I'll send you a couple of it.
Yeah, and
see if you like it.
And do you play some instrument, or do you specialize on?
I play a little bit of piano.
Okay,
that's how I make my songs, but not enough to play on the show. No, yeah. They would like ding ding ding. They don't want that. They don't want that. And percussions. I do percussions.
Okay,
mm-hmm. Okay. That's awesome.
Okay. Good to know.
Yes.
See.
We shared all that information. She's going. We'll put all that information up on the YouTube channel. We'll put it on the podcast channel. You'll be able to go see this person. You have to see her. She's amazing.
Yeah, a lot of energy in that moment.
Gracias.
Yes.
Thank you, Jimena, and everybody.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful
day. It's been a pleasure.
Day.